because I didn't want the computer to make too much noise. But yeah, I've been playing a little bit. As you can see, I am level 31. And we got a little bit of everything, probably more than we need, but just wanted to make sure I had everything possible, so here we go. Loading up the game. And we will spawn deck. seconds come after you. Every so often, once your sanity drops, I think it's below 50%, so we are still good for right now. So we have the ghostwriting book, which if you leave it, the ghost can actually write in it, but apparently it takes a little bit of time sometimes, so it's good to put it in there early, and you know, you have the ability to kind of do other things and wait and come back and check it. So we put the book down, and we're just gonna take a look around here with the EMF again. I was trying to get a level 5, as that is a type of evidence. See now, the ghost is actually flickering the lights, but we're gonna check for some fingerprints, and there you go, we got a handprint on the door. So we're actually gonna put that in as evidence number 1. So fingerprints, and you're gonna have 3 evidence pieces of evidence. And you know, based off of that, it'll actually narrow it down for you at the bottom of that page, but based off of your evidence, and sometimes it can be confusing, so you have to kind of go off of things that you're noticing outside of the evidence, but based off of the evidence, you can narrow down the type of ghost, and I think there's like 10 or 12 types, something like that. So yeah, we're gonna try to get some more evidence to figure out what type of ghost is haunting this farmhouse here. So we got the video camera. We put it on a tripod, and we're gonna bring that inside. Set it up so that we can come back to the van. And pretty much we want to look for ghost orbs, as that is another type of evidence as well. So we're going to try to get a nice wide shot of the room, make sure we turn the camera on, the green light, and we're going to go back down to the van, like I mentioned, and see if we see any floating ghost orbs. We're just going to drop the camera there. I think I wanted to make sure again that I had enough spots to bring in multiple items. So you can see our sanity is starting to get a little low, but not too much lower than it was. But I guess we're going to take a sanity pill just to be on the safe side. So one of the objectives, I believe, is to cleanse the area with smudge sticks, which is what we have right now. And as you can see right there, I think we'll see another one, but there was a ghost orb, that little round ball of light that went across the screen there. So actually, with the two types of evidence we already have, it actually narrowed it down. So the only ghost that can have those two things, ghost orb and fingerprints, was a poltergeist. It said the other piece of evidence was a spirit box, so if it talks back to you, which I guess we'll try for as well, but I think we try for it, I'm not sure. But I want to try to get some of these objectives done, so we light this smudge stick with the lighter, and we just walk around the area, and you can see the smoke coming off of it. And it only lasts for a little while, so we axe from hunting with a crucifix. Again, that's optional. I still haven't gotten the hang of using the crucifix, so I'm probably not going to, I don't think I did that in this one. I also didn't want to really risk getting killed or anything on the first video that I do with this, so another reason I didn't go with that. But we're going to try to find that third piece of evidence here with the spirit box. And you can see the ghost actually the door over a little bit, and certain pieces of evidence or interactions the ghost has with the physical world you can take pictures of, which count as pretty much extra money. So that's cool, and you can use the money to purchase equipment and stuff like that, so it's always helpful. Oh, there we go. The ghost did respond. I didn't remember. He pretty much wants us to go away, I think is what it's saying. And he hates us, so that's not good. Definitely not a good sign if the ghost is saying the word hate. So yeah, we pretty much got our evidence there. There was no writing in the book. That they provide you with. And as a little like side mission, there's usually a bone somewhere within the house or the building that you're in that you can take a picture of and collect for extra money. So I think I was just running around here quickly seeing if I could find that, but I don't remember. I don't was able to find it this time. Usually it's fairly obvious, but I don't know, I just couldn't find it in this one. I probably passed it and didn't realize, but that's okay. You know, I don't think we'd be getting a ton of money anyway. It's not really going to give us a whole lot more if we get the bone, and of course the higher difficulty that you're on, the more money you get, but being on amateur difficulty here, you know, we weren't going to get too much money to begin with anyway. So, we couldn't find the bone, but we do have to put in our third piece of evidence as the spirit box. And you can see the only ghost type in there famous ghosts. A poltergeist, also known as a noisy ghost, can manipulate objects around it to spread fear into its victims. Throw a huge amount of objects. Ineffective in an empty room. It has each ghost's strength and weaknesses, and then at the bottom says what type of evidence you need to find in order for it to be that ghost. Plus, of course, a little summary at the top. So, Richard Jackson, we know you are a poltergeist. Thank you for not attacking us. We did have a nice little successful run here as we see another ghost orb there. And, yeah, you press the keypad to finish it. And you can see we got it right. We got some money for each objective. And each piece of evidence and other things like that. And yeah, we did pretty good. So we're back here in the home base, and I really like this little game that they have. Little basketball game. It's really, really hard to begin with, at least it was for me, but kind of got in the hang of it. Anyway, I believe we're gonna look at some pictures briefly before I end it here. friend of mine and with a ghost. But yeah, I hope you're all doing well. I hope you're having a relaxing time watching this.